So how do we make the diagnosis of gastroparesis? Well, the gold standard really is something called a gastric emptying study, which in this day and age is a pretty vague test. It's a nuclear medicine test, so the patient eats either like an egg salad sandwich or some oatmeal. It's been labeled with a radioactive protein, and they sit or lay down in front of a big Geiger counter, for lack of a better term, just a big disc, and it measures the radioactivity in the stomach. And over time, we see that radioactivity decrease, and we know that the food is moving through. And typically, we want to see about 50% of the radioactive material move out of the stomach in a four-hour period. Ideally, the test is done over 4 hours. Lots of time it's done over 2 hours with extrapolation out to 4 hours. That's fine if it's really abnormal, but if it's close and there's some concerns, then probably a four-hour study is the best thing. There are some other tests that have been done. They're really not the gold standard. There's breath testing. There's wireless capsules where you eat a capsule and you see how long it stays in the stomach, and the change in the pH that's sensed by a remote sensor tells us. Endoscopy can be quite helpful though. So if you have to have an endoscopy for any reason, and nausea is a good reason to have an endoscopy, and your endoscopist goes down into your stomach and they've made sure that you didn't eat anything overnight, so it's been at least 12 or maybe 18 hours, and they see that your stomach's full of food, almost by definition, unless there's a medication causing some sort of a side effect, that would be diagnostic of poor gastric emptying. There's some pictures you'll see on these next slides of images of what a gastric emptying test look like. You can see it's not super scientific, but it's what we have, and it seems to work to get people in the door for the diagnosis. Then it's really up to the clinician to say, okay, what kind of gastroparesis is this, and how are you best going to treat it?